Routes for drug administration are of two types, local routes and systemic routes. The local routes are done during the localized lesions at accessible sites and for drugs whose systemic absorption from these sites is lacking. It is of three main types, topical route, arterial supply and the deeper tissues. First one, the topical route is the external application of the drug to the surface for localized action. It is mainly carried out in the skin, oropharyngeal, eyes, ear canal, anal canal and the vagina. And in general, the antiseptics and the astringents and the hemostatics are applied as toothpastes, mouthwashes, gargles and lozenges. In the deeper tissues, in the deep areas the drug are given through the syringe and needle where the systemic absorption is low. The drug is given through two types of injection, intrathecal injection and the intra-articular injection. And then the arterial supply, it is done by intra-arterial injection in the arteries. And for example, a femoral or a branchial artery is given with anti-cancer drugs. And then the systemic routes. The systemic routes are absorbed into bloodstream and distributed all over through the body, through the damaged tissue also, through the circulation. And the first one is the oral, which is an enteral route. Enteral means it involves the intestine also. And oral route is the oldest and commonest, and it is also safer and more convenient. It is given in two forms, powder form and liquid form. In powder, dosage forms are like powders, tablets, capsules, spansules, draggies, then molder tablets and gastrointestinal therapeutic drugs. Then liquid dosage forms are given as elixirs, syrups, emulsions and mixtures. Then the sublingual or buccal route, which is also an enteral route. In this, the pellet containing the drug is placed under the tongue or crushed in the mouth and spread all over the buccal mucosa. And the advantage of this is the liver is bypassed and drugs with high first pass metabolism can be absorbed directly into systemic circulation. And the substances which are passed through this sublingual or buccal route is glycerol, trinitrate, buprenorphine. These aminooxytocin drugs, these three drugs are given through, mainly these three are given through the sublingual route. Then the rectal route, which is also an enteral route, and in this the drugs are into rectum or given into rectum as suppositories or a retention edema. And it is usually given for unpleasant drugs and for patients having recurrent vomiting. And if there is irritant drugs, it may cause a rectal inflammation also. And the drugs given through this route are indomethacin, diazepam and ergotamine. You just remember any one or two names, it's enough. Then the cutaneous route. In this, the highly lipid-soluble drugs are applied over the skin for slow and prolonged absorption. And in this, the liver is bypassed and the drug will be incorporated like an ointment and then it will be rubbed on the skin surface. Then the fifth one is the inhalation. In this, volatile liquids or gases are inhaled. Then absorption will be done on the surface of alveoli. And when the need for drug is enough, then it will be expired from the alveoli. So this is a controlled administration. And if any irritant vapors are present in the alveoli, then it may cause the inflammation of the respiratory tract. Then the nasal. Mucous membrane of the nose readily absorbs most drugs. So in this, digestive juices and liver are also bypassed. So gonadotropin releasing hormone agonists and desmopressin are applied as a spray or nebulized solution. Then the seventh one is the parenteral route. Parenteral route is that means it Par means beyond and enteral means intestinal, as we have seen before. So parenteral is beyond intestinal. So parenteral means the administration by injection, that is the drug is directly introduced into the tissue fluid or blood without having to cross enteral mucosa. So it directly enters the damaged portion or the injured site. And in this, the drug action is very fast and surer, and it is always given during the emergent situations. And in this, gastric irritation, vomiting will not be provoked. And it is used even in unconscious, uncooperative or vomiting patients. And it has no chances for interference by food or digestive juices because it directly enters the injured tissue or injured site. So, and then the liver is bypassed in this. But the disadvantages of this parenteral route is that it must be highly sterilized, and the things brought for this are highly costly, and it is invasive and more painful, and it also needs some assistance. So it cannot be done without assistance. And there are chances for local tissue injury also, and it is more riskier than the oral route. There are four types of parenteral routes: subcutaneous, intramuscular, intravenous and intradermal. The subcutaneous its absorption is very slower, but the drug is deposited in the loose subcutaneous tissue, which is richly supplied by the nerves. And in the subcutaneous, self-injection is possible and should be avoided in patients who are vasoconstricted. And then the intramuscular injection, which is the most common one, it is IM, and in this the absorption is faster and injected in large skeletal muscles like deltoid, which is present in the arm, and triceps, gluteus maximus and rectus femoris. These four muscles are the common sites for injections. And then self-injection is impossible, and it is less painful also, but deep penetration is needed, and it is avoided in patients taking anticoagulant medication. And then intravenous, it is infused slowly over hearts in one of the superficial veins. Effects produce immediately, and it is of great value in emergency. So mainly it is used for syncopes. Syncopes is nothing but fainting. When a patient faints, they will suddenly give this intravenous infusion. And the drugs given in aqueous solutions, and these drugs are short acting. For example, sodium nitroprusside, and the case response is accurate in intravenous. And another, it is also most risky because the heart, brain, all the vital organs are exposed when the drug is given at a higher concentration. And another major risk is that the possibility of air embolism may occur if they are given for a long time. And intradermal injection, in this the drug is injected into the skin, raising a bulb. And example is BCG vaccine. And sensitive testing. Intradermal injection, it is given rarely, and it is done only for specific purposes, and it must be done very carefully. And this is a picture which overall defines these routes for drug administration. See, the intramuscular injection, intravenous injection, transdermal patch, and first part metabolism in lungs, in liver, in intestinal wall, and how the oral tablet enters the stomach. And these are all given in this diagram. You can look over it.